Islam came to us and so on, yeah?
Like that.
Like
superior.
You Arab came to us, we were not Muslims, and you this and that. Firstly, we ask, okay? They say, you are following Arab's culture, yeah? Firstly, let us analyze, is it Arab culture or not? When the Prophet Muhammad was sent as a messenger, the first people that rejected him, his own people. But if it was Arab culture, why are they rejecting it?
Yes.
So Islam is Arab culture. Secondly, what was the argument against Prophet Muhammad Sallam? Are we going to leave our forefathers' religion?
Yes.
So what these people are doing, exactly what Abu Lahab was doing, Abu Jahl. So therefore, Prophet Muhammad Sallam, what he came with, it was not Arab thing. Otherwise, the Arab, they should accept it. Otherwise, they would have used the argument of, are we going to leave off our forefathers' religion and follow you? Because if the Prophet Muhammad, where he came with, is the Arab religion, why Abu Jahl, Abu Lahab, Utbah ibn Rabi'a, Umayyah ibn Khalif, and so on are rejecting it? Walid ibn Mughir rejecting it. Because they knew he has nothing to do with the earth. It's coming from the sama', from the sky. You know, from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I mean above the sky. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's it. Thirdly, what I say to people, okay, before Islam came to North Africa, your forefathers that you want to go back to before Islam, are they the first people that Allah created? Oh, there were many people in North Africa for thousand years. So what they were upon? Why you only want to go before Islam? Why don't you go back 1,000 years before that?
If you want to be truthful.
Be truthful. And let us refute them. We say, okay, let us go back to our forefather. Who is our forefather? Adam.
Of course.
Adam was a Muslim. So we are going back to our forefather.
Yes.
So we are following our Adam. So everyone should go back. If you are using this argument, let us follow our forefather. You go back to Adam alayhi salam. Also, fourthly, if my forefather or my father, may Allah have mercy upon him, was upon misguidance, am I going to follow him because my father was upon misguidance? Or my country is upon misguidance, I'm going to say, you know, my country, they worship a monkey, so I'm going to start worshiping monkey too. Or they worship a chicken or a tree or a cow. No, Allah gave me intellect. And Allah gave me natural inclination. So this argument that people are using against Islam, Islam came to Afghanistan. No. Also, fifthly, this land, the whole world belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Does not belong to your father, your grandfather. Because you're going to die. And when you die, none of this part of this country is going to come with you. You're going to live naked. You're going to be, understand? So we have to understand that. I had to mention this because sometimes people say, Islam came to us and we were this, we were that. You understand? But alhamdulillah, Ottoman Empire at the beginning was good, yes. Defend Islam, spread Islam. But at the end, akhi, they start following their desires. And this is what happened. And this every civilization, every dynasty. The dynasty of Umayyad, the dynasty of Abbasiyin, the dynasty of Salajika, the dynasty of what they call it, Uthmaniyin, and so on. Many dynasty of Murabitin, the dynasty of Muwahideen, the dynasty of Mariniyin. That's Sunnah Allah fi khalqih. That's Allah's Sunnah, you know. When you follow Allah's teaching, you'll be on the top. When you start going against Allah's teaching, and so Allah, one of Allah's names, what is it? Al Khafidu wal Rafi'u. Allah debases and raises. So he debases some people and he raises some people. And sometimes he debases the other people and he raises the other people. It's Sunnah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala based upon his wisdom and his justice. Does it make sense? Alhamdulillah, min wa iyyakum. Alhamdulillah.
Another question, if you don't mind.
Yeah, alhamdulillah, we are here to help one another, inshallah.
To a Muslim brother, I've come to find out that he is a Shiite.
Yeah, Shia.
And talking normally, and he said something interesting that I didn't have an answer to because I don't know.
Yeah.
The question was, you know, the temporary marriage that existed once upon a time.
Yeah.
For Muslim men who were traveling.
Yeah.
Right.
In a war.
Right?
Yeah.
He said to me, the reason why we still do this, the Shiites.
Yeah.
Is because the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did not forbid it. Who did forbid is Umar.
Radiallahu anhu.
Yeah.
That is not true.
I said to him, how? Show me some proof. Is this?
It's in Bukhari, showed you.
He showed me in Bukhari. I was gobsmacked. I said, what the hell?
Yeah, yeah.
And I didn't know what to respond.
Yeah, yeah. So that's not true.
For me to ask.
Okay, in Bukhari, he didn't show you the hadith Bukhari. What happened? The hadith that made Mut'ah haram, the hadith Ali ibn Abi Talib in Sahih al-Bukhari, okay? The hadith Ali ibn Abi Talib, now Umar ibn al-Khattab, because after this hadith, many Sahaba didn't know about it. That's why Jabir ibn Abdullah used to practice it. Ibn Abbas, one of them, And Umar ibn Khattab, when he noticed during his lifetime, some people do practice, so he stood up on a minbar and he said, Prophet made it haram.
Uh-huh.
Understand?
Okay.
So it was haram. Prophet made it haram. However, it was not known to everyone.
Uh-huh.
That's why, for example, different way of reciting Quran. Different way of reciting Quran was not familiar to other Sahaba. Uthman ibn Affan stood up on a minbar and he said, how many of you are witness that the Messenger of Allah said, Unzil al-Quran ala sab'ati ahruf. The Quran was reviewed upon seven ways of reciting it. And Sahaba stood up, the other Sahaba. You see, so doesn't mean here, first Uthman ibn Affan, he made it up. No, Uthman ibn Affan narrating that Safiq said, which some Sahaba or Tabi'in were unaware of. And that's what Umar ibn Khattab did.
Perfect.
You know, it reminds me of,
you
know, brother Anwar, you know, my Anwar, he comes with me, he has a birthmark.
Yes, yes, yes.
What happened to him once, he said, I was speaking to a Shia guy. So he said, Shia guy, why you have to hit yourself with a knife? You know, this is not from Islam, you know?
Of course.
He said, what? It's in your book. He said to Anwar, it's in your book. Anwar said, what? In our book? He said, yeah, Prophet Muhammad did it. Anwar was like, what? He said, it's in Bukhari. I'm going to ask you, which hadith he mentioned? Guess which hadith he mentioned? The hadith of hijama. You know hijama? Hijama, you know hijama, cupping.
Yeah,
hijama. He said the hadith hijama, Rasulullah cut himself. Look how twisted they are. You understand?
Very deviant.
You know? And that's what Allah said in the Quran. As for those who have disease in their heart, they look for unclear verses. Instead of following the clear verse, the clear proofs, like, you know, I'll give you an example of that. When you speak to atheists, they can clearly see the universe is designed and it's a program and everything, but he said there's possibility. It can come from nowhere. So what they're doing, they leave the clear proofs and they go to unclear proofs. And that's what the people of desires do.
Yeah.
They leave the unclear and they go to, they leave the clear verses and the clear verses. The Christians likewise. Clearly Jesus said, the only true God is the Father. Clearly said that, okay? He said, that's not the hour. They leave all of that, they say, but Jesus said, I and the Father are one.
You know, they neglect their intellect. It makes them no different from an animal.
That's what Allah said in some of the verses, that I was an animal. Why there was the animals? Because Allah gave the animal. Because the animals sometimes, when they see the shepherd leading them, they will follow him. Because
yeah.
They can see where he's taking them. You know, even us, we can see the proofs. Some not us, alhamdulillah, we're Muslims, alhamdulillah, we for Quran and Sunnah. Some people they see the proofs, but they go and guess it.
Yes.
So it was an animal.
Yeah, of course.
As this tafsir of Shaqiqi, rahmahu ta'ala, mentioned that. That's what Allah said. Bal adallu sabila. They are worse in animals. They go and guess what is not by necessity. They go and guess the proofs and so on. Yeah, so, alhamdulillah, barakallahu fiik.
I go over there, somebody else can speak.
Inshallah, no worries, may Allah bless you. Wa sallallahu ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Wa sallam sliman kathira. Many brothers here, let me give you a reminder, brothers. May Allah bless you all. You know, I always like to give reminders to myself first and to everyone. You know, when you come to speaker's corner, try to not listen to anyone that speaks. Because you don't want to have the wrong information about Islam. And one of the side effects of Speaker's Corner, or one of the major side effects of Speaker's Corner, allows everyone to speak. Anyone speaks about the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And also, my brothers, sometimes I know you have the jealousy for Islam, you have the ghira for Islam, and you see someone speaking against Islam, don't even get involved into this discussion if you don't have enough knowledge. The best thing is to leave them. Because sometimes what you do, they can utilize you to say, look, a Muslim, he couldn't answer the question. You know, sometimes leave them. Like I see some people keep speaking to Hattoon. Hattoon is worse than hyena. I still call her hyena, but she's worse than hyena. I think even the hyena, they freed themselves from her. That woman, she's a gift from Allah. But say how? She's a gift from Allah. She's helping people to become Muslims. When the people see the behavior of a Christian and they see people accept Islam, they think, oh, subhanAllah. Alhamdulillah. You see, because look as a Muslims, look to our discussions, look to other brothers' discussions. We speak with respect, we break down what is Islam is true and everything. She's just screaming. Everyone can shout. You don't have to have a qualification from Oxford University to start shouting like a crazy person. No, you can do it. Crack can do it and speak in the bush green. In other. So if you start shouting and screaming at people and just bringing Quran and there's a hole in it, you're on a crackhead same. I mean, even some crackhead better than her. To be honest, well, I have to be that serious. Crackhead are better than her. So why some Muslims keep, and there's a brother who keeps speaking to her. Akhi, have ways, you know, just, it's like someone scratching and in the window or something. So speak to her. She's insult Allah and His Messenger. You go speak to her. Don't speak to her. Do you understand? Instead of speaking to her, you could have been listening to a talk, reading the Quran, listening to Quran, doing something that will benefit you in this life and the hereafter. Why we keep wasting our time speaking to Hatun? It is not entertainment. Wallahi, some brothers, may Allah forgive them. I remember one brother came to me and he said, Akhi, speak to so and so. See, I want to see how you do it because I want to laugh. I said, well, this is a circus or something. What do you mean this is a comedy show? I said, go fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, go learn, study, man. You know, and some of them come because this place is full of doubt. A lot of doubt. So don't, if you don't have enough knowledge, you don't want to come and listen to people like Angus Islam. Alhamdulillah, this doubt can be refuted. But the best way to stay away from it. Alhamdulillah. Look, the way we break down Islam, have you ever heard Christian men here from this call us to Christianity standing in front of the camera and explaining to people why Christianity is the truth? You can't. How are you going to say Jesus is God? God is not human being, but Jesus is human being, but He's God. God is not a baby, but baby is God. Jesus is a baby. Akhi, who's going to understand that? How can you compare this so complicated there? Doesn't make any sense, irrational, illogical, impossible, to there's only one God. Perfect. Based upon His mercy, justice, and wisdom, trust people amongst us to clarify the truth to us. And He said the prophets and messengers, shaitan a shaitan. You'll never be able to compare this beautiful deen, Islam, to any way of life that they have. Christianity is dying, man. Look at this church. I have four churches behind my house, empty. Even on Sunday, it's closed. I think which day they worship God is there, guys? Closed down. You know, closed down. The countries that were known in the 60s, the 50s, 19th century, 20th century, the Western world, they were proper propagating what's Christianity. They invaded our country, like, you know, France, when he came to Algeria, to Morocco, Spain, and so on. They want to spread Christianity, you know? Yeah. But now, those countries who were known to propagate Christianity, they left it. The Western world has left Christianity. They don't care. Here you can disrespect Jesus in Britain, in America, disrespect Him. You can draw Jesus and urinate on Him, they will do nothing to you. But if you speak against some people, some group of people, they will put you in prison. To show you Jesus, that's like, they don't, this country and other countries of the world, they don't stop saying this country is Christian. And with the argument they say, we allow you to have a mosque here. Christians, you're not allowing us because this is not a Christian country. This country, the aqidah is not Christianity. The aqidah is other things. For example, from the aqidah to propagate LGBTQ. So if you open a therapy, like for example, if you say I'm going to open a clinic, you know, what they call it, to help people who they are gay, to bring them back, because I believe they're doing it wrong, they will shut it down. Because why? You go and guess the aqidah now. But church is not aqidah of the state anymore. So this argument of you allowing us to have mosque here, just change it. Doesn't work. They allow you to open church as well here. Because this country is not. But if you open something against the aqidah, which is the aqidah of the Western world now, then they will shut it down. Likewise in our countries, that would go against aqidah, they shut it down. Likewise here, they do it. You understand? Alhamdulillah. So my point here is that we have to understand, alhamdulillah, look at Islam, subhanAllah. Even though the war that is being waged against Islam, you see Christian missionaries, atheists, militants, Jewish missionaries, Hindus, Buddhists, missionaries, they come together against Islam, even though they disagree with one another. Why they come against Islam? Even though Muslim countries are weak, because they know Islam is powerful. So what is making Islam powerful is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the creator of everything, the Almighty. And they cannot defeat Islam. They're gonna go crazy. How is religion, the countries are weak, the people are weak, but this religion is so powerful, defeating many people, many people accept Islam. In Britain, majority of people who accept Islam are women. In France, same thing. In Germany, same thing. In the United States, States.
Well, yeah. You're right.
Of course, I am right. Of course, I am right. Anyway, not the people, by the way, to clarify. The people are good. America's people, I've met some people, they're good. May Allah guide them and guide everyone, inshallah. The point here is that they are fighting against Islam, but subhanAllah, this deen is taking over. People accept Islam without using force, without using spoon, without using knife. Rather, they, America is using force against the Muslim countries. If Muslim countries want to implement Sharia, they will use a force by cutting them off. Look, but no one speaks about it. You know, you know what I don't like as well? Malahidatul Arab. The Arab atheist. The Arab atheist.
I don't mean to disturb you.
No,
but I've seen you many times on YouTube.
Allah bless you, akhi.
I'm glad to meet you.
It's my pleasure to meet you, Allah bless you. The Arab atheist, they make me sick. You know, they don't do nothing, they just talk. They say Islam is holding our countries to be civilized. It's not Islam. Because there is no country that is ruled by Islam like the way it should be ruled. You know, alhamdulillah, there's other countries, mashallah, they practice Islam more than other countries. Alhamdulillah, you can see, it's been civilized, alhamdulillah. The Arab atheists, they're embarrassment for the people. They talk as if they can resolve the whole problem. But again, atheism, there is no rules, there is no regulations. You can sleep with your mother, it's okay for them. You can do whatever you like. So how atheism is going to help the world? Rather, the proof that atheism is destruction upon mankind, which proof is it? No, what is it? Which country implemented and destroyed itself? Which country that implemented atheism?
France.
No, before France. Soviet Union, they implemented Darwinian evolution, destroyed the people. They killed many people. You see, look at it. So atheism is the worst philosophical ideology that ever existed. Because there is no objective good or bad. Whatever you decide is good, it's good. Today is good, huh?
There's no belief.
There's no criteria. That's why when you speak to atheists, don't just ask him what is your criteria to determine what is right, what is wrong. There's no criteria. They believe everything, they can change any time. Today you're not allowed to sleep with your mother, tomorrow they can change too. Say yes, okay, sleep with your mother.
Stalin, he's an atheist.
Stalin, Mo, and what's his name? Lenin.
Lenin.
Lenin, I said Lenin. Lenin. Anyway, alhamdulillah for Islam. May Allah keep us firm upon Islam and Sunnah. Yes, we are in this country. Alhamdulillah, utilize your time wisely. Read and give da'wah. Many people accept Islam here. These people are hungry for Islam because they know guidance. Yes, they have technology and everything, but they don't have a peace of the heart. That is in Islam. The peace of the heart is in Islam. And also, Islam, the best civilization is Islamic civilization. Andalusia. Allahu Akbar, Baghdad. You know, subhanAllah, Abu Qasim al-Zahrawi, one of the great scientists, may Allah have mercy upon him. And Ibn Haytham, may Allah have mercy upon him. And so on. When Muslims left Islam, Allah humiliated them. When Christians left Christianity, they become more advanced. So, alhamdulillah. So, us to become more advanced and civilized, we need Islam. Not just us, the whole world needs Islam. That's why the world is drowning in darkness. People are, sorry, I just want to finish the point. People committing suicide. It's crazy how many people commit suicide. You know, one of the most happiest country, Sweden, Japan. The suicide rate there is so high. So how are they happy? You know what it means happy? They got good money and they have good house. That's not happiness. That's not happiness. I can eat one bread as long as I'm happy, content and everything. You see, subhanAllah. وَمَنْ أَعْرَضَ عَنْ ذِكْرِي فَإِنَّ لَهُ مَعِيشْتًا دَنْكَى. Whoever turns away from my remembrance will have a miserable life. أَلَا بِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ تَطْمَئِنُّ الْقُلُوبِ. Is it not with the remembrance of Allah that you will find peace and tranquility? It is indeed, walhamdulillah. Yes, brother, sorry, akhi, you want to mention something?
About deception. So 9/11, we all know it was a deception. Deceive the general public so they can go to war with Muslim countries, right?
America did it before, yes.
Yeah. So it's all about deception, right?
Of course,
deceiving the public, right?
Yeah.
So as Muslims, when they show portrayed these images of Muslims killing blah blah blah, so all these so-called terrorism acts, we all, as Muslims knew it's all bullshit.
No, but some of them is true, okay. Some of course, there's Khawarij, they don't care. It's yes. ISIS followers, yes. They do kill innocent people.
But the ones
some of it is true.
About that made major news, so like the London bombing, 9/11, the Spanish bombing.
I don't know about London bombing, brother. I don't agree with you. Maybe not 11 days, dodgy. Yes. But the point here is, look, I agree. Yes, sometimes they do that. And they did it to one of the, which country? So America has a company in one of these countries. And it was a banana company.
Panama.
Huh?
Panama,
something like that. What they did, they had to lie against the leader. He was a Soviet. They said he was a communist.
Yeah.
And he was not communist, just to change people's minds and to for America to go invade, you know, to claim. So we know that already. But as a Muslim, what we say, that's what I said. Sometimes I said to me, that people tell me, okay, how do you know what happened was done by a Muslim? I said, regardless, Muslim or not, we are against it and we are free from it. That's what I have to understand. But yes, without any doubt, okay, even the, that's what I say all the time. people in power, those who want good, evil for, because I always mention this example. Imagine I'm in a city, okay? And I'm making money from banks. I'm making money from prostitute companies, gambling companies, alcohol companies, and all of that. And you come to my city, and you're a Muslim teaching people that it's evil and stay away from it. How I'm gonna look at you? I'm gonna look at you as evil. So what I'm gonna do, because I'm a rich person, I'm gonna utilize my money to make you look bad. And this is what's happening right now. These people are utilizing their money to make Islam look bad through media, even though Islam is the best solution for mankind. Islam is the best solution for you as individual and as for collectively. I'm talking about alcohol.
They have penetrated deep.
Yeah,
alhamdulillah. In Mecca, there's McDonald's.
Going back to
McDonald's in Mecca.
There's no problem, McDonald's halal brother. We all love burger, man.
Islamic countries have
chicken burger.
The least crimes, yani.
No, but McDonald's okay, okay. Who loves McDonald's here? Of course, it's not good. It's a fry. But we were just talking here. It's halal, though. If it's in the shop, there's McDonald's in Morocco, there's McDonald's in Mecca, there's McDonald's, no problem with that. It's halal, it's food, no problem. Some people want to eat it.